From the Tribune News Network, this is News Break. I'm Krishna Russell. Prime Minister Dr. Hubert Minnis will give notice of his intention to extend the country's state of emergency beyond August 13th, when the House of Assembly reconvenes tomorrow in response to the current resurgence of COVID-19 cases. Dr. Minnis will give a national address tonight at 8 p.m. to inform Bahamians of his administration's plans related to the current COVID-19 emergency orders and the country's future transition to a new legislative approach. The country has been under a state of emergency since March 2020. Government officials have said the discontinuation of COVID-19 emergency powers orders would largely depend on infection rates and the behavior of residents. They had also indicated a few weeks ago the Minnis administration's intention to let the orders expire this month. However, since then, the nation has seen a sustained uptick of virus-related cases and hospitalizations as well as deaths, with officials attributing the latest spike to the presence of COVID-19 variants and a relaxed adherence to the current health measures. The charred remains of a woman and two children were discovered after a fire at a residence on Cocoa Plum Road off of East Street was extinguished yesterday. Although police have not officially identified the deceased, relatives told the Tribune that Tamaine Parent, 43, Renisha Perriette, 11, and Taylor Lucent, 7, tragically died in that blaze. Director of Fire Services Superintendent Kendrick Morris said while not confirmed, it is believed four people lived in the home that caught fire. One of those individuals managed to escape the blaze. Investigators are still looking into the cause of that fire. The Consultant Physician Staff Association has again expressed concern over the continued increase in COVID-19 cases that has overwhelmed the nation's healthcare system. This comes after the country recorded 228 new cases of COVID-19 on Thursday, 118 on Friday, and an additional 169 on Sunday. Thursday's figures represented the highest number of cases recorded in the Bahamas in one single day. 9 additional COVID-19 deaths were also reported on Friday. More than 100 people are in hospital with the virus. Despite the significant roles that medical workers play, the CPSA yesterday said physicians are still not being engaged in meaningful dialogue with government officials on the way forward from the pandemic. The physicians are also urging the Bahamian people to keep following the current health measures and warned that fully vaccinated people can still spread the virus. The Royal Bahamas Defense Force is actively searching for possible migrants after an empty sloop was found drifting in waters approximately 8 nautical miles off of Goulding Key on Saturday. In a statement, the RBDF said after the agency received initial reports from the U.S. Coast Guard liaison officer that two Haitian sloops had left Haiti, air and sea assets were immediately deployed to conduct search operations in the areas of the possible routes taken by the sloops. Additional assistance in that search also included aerial reconnaissance by the U.S. Coast Guard fixed-wing aircraft, a drone, and members of the RBDF Commando Squadron Unit, which conducted searches on several keys in the Exuma chain. Your complete news and information source, this is the Tribune News Network. In international news, members of the U.S. military would be required to have the COVID-19 vaccine beginning September 15th under a plan announced by the Pentagon Monday and endorsed by President Joe Biden. That deadline could be pushed up if the vaccine receives final FDA approval or infection rates continue to rise. Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin said he plans to seek the president's approval to make the vaccines mandatory no later than mid-September or immediately upon licensure from the Food and Drug Administration. He added that if infection rates rise and potentially affect military readiness, he will not hesitate to act sooner or recommend a different course to the government. Earth is getting so hot that temperatures in about a decade will probably blow past a level of warming that world leaders have sought to prevent, according to a report released today by the United Nations called A Code Red for Humanity. It's just guaranteed that it's going to get worse, said report co-author Linda Mearns, a senior climate scientist at the U.S. National Center for Atmospheric Research. Nowhere to run, nowhere to hide, she continued. But scientists also eased back a bit on the likelihood of the absolute worst climate catastrophes. The authoritative Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change report, which calls climate change clearly human-caused and unequivocal and an established fact, makes more precise and warmer forecasts for the 21st century than it did last time it was issued in 2013. The Tribune's AccuWeather update, a service of Bahamas Power and Light Company. High-pressure ridging will continue to support moderate to locally fresh winds over the Bahamas. The public is advised to remain hydrated and limit direct sun exposure due to soaring heat indices. Beachgoers in the central and southeast Bahamas should exercise caution along east coast beaches due to the risk of rip currents. For all areas, it'll be partly to mostly sunny, hot, and a bit breezy, with widely scattered showers and the chance of an afternoon thunderstorm. Storm today, becoming mostly fair to partly cloudy tonight. A small craft caution is in effect in the central and southeast Bahamas. Winds easterly at 10 to 15 knots in the northwest Bahamas and 15 to 20 knots in the central and southeast Bahamas. Seas 2 to 4 feet in the northwest Bahamas and 4 to 6 feet elsewhere. We'll have a daytime high temperature of 93 degrees, a heat index of 104, and an overnight low temperature of 77. The sun will set this afternoon at 7:48 and will rise tomorrow morning at 6:42. That's Newsbreak. Details of the day's top stories in the Tribune newspaper, now on the streets. Or stay up to date online at Tribune242.com.